Hi there, Michael here. Welcome to my guide to using Distrobox in Bazzite. Distrobox allows you to use almost any Linux distro inside your terminal by creating a container of that distro using either Dropbox or Podman. This container is tightly integrated with your host system and is able to share your home directory, external storage devices, USB devices, plus it can execute terminal and graphical apps from within Distrobox. As you'll find in this video, Bazzite and Distrobox go very well together. If you'd like to try out Bazzite, you can download it from bazzite.gg and there are installation instructions on the website. Without further ado, let's install a distro with Distrobox. We're going to start by launching BoxBuddy. BoxBuddy is a simple GUI for Distrobox. Now let's click on the Add button and we're going to select Ubuntu. There are a number of distros that you can choose, but I'm the most familiar with Ubuntu and so are many others. I'm also going to give it a name and we're going to click on the Create button. Now, as you can see, it's busy. It's currently downloading the container. Now that our container is up and running, there are four ways in which we can enter this container. I'm going to close it first. The one way is we can open it from within BoxBuddy. Another way that we can open it is by just for searching for it in the menu. We called it Ubuntu. So if we look for Ubuntu, we can launch it. The third way of entering it is through the terminal Texas. We just type Distrobox, enter Ubuntu. This will jump into the container. And this last way is a unique feature in Texas where we can click on this little drop down over here and we can just click on the container and we can jump straight into it. Now that we're in our Ubuntu container and we can see that we're in our Ubuntu container, if we look after the username, you can see that you'll have at and the name of the container there. What we're going to do now is we're going to install an application using apt in Ubuntu. What I'm going to install here is Audacity. Here I'm going to type sudo apt install Audacity. And let's just wait for that to install. Now that it's installed, we can launch the application by just typing Audacity. Here when the application launches, if we look at the Save As project, we can see everything that's available in our home directory. It's as if this application is installed on the host machine. Now, as you'd imagine, it's not that convenient having to launch the application from the terminal. Now, there are two ways that we can add the application to the menu. The first way is in BoxBuddy itself. We can click on View Applications, and then we can see the application and we can add it to the menu. The other way that we can add the application is to type the following: Distrobox export dash dash app Audacity. Now, if we search for Audacity in our menu, we can see it right here. And note, you can see in brackets at the end of the name that it has the name of the container that it's going to launch on. Now let's install a terminal application. What I'm going to do is I'm going to install Glances, which is a terminal-based system monitor. Like Audacity, we're going to open up the terminal, switch to our Ubuntu container, and we're going to type sudo apt install Glances. And now we're just going to wait for that to install. We can launch it with the command Glances. And as you can see, it's showing Glances application as normal, where you can monitor your system resources, much like BTOP and TOP and some of the others. Now that we've confirmed that the application works, to close a command line application, we can use the key combination Control C. Now, we would also like to have glances available in our host system. However, terminal applications work a little differently. First, we need the full path of the application. Here we'll use the command which glances. This will give us the full path from where it's running from. Now, we're going to use the command distrobox export, but instead of dash dash app, we're going to use dash dash bin, and we're going to type the full path of the application that we're exporting. Now, when we press enter, this application will now be available on the host system. So if I close the terminal for the container, open Texas again, just going to jump to full screen, and I'm going to type glances. And as you can see, the application is now running as if we were running it as a native application in Bazzite. And I'm just going to close it with Control C as before. As you can see, DistroBox really makes it easy to run software from any distro without needing to distro hop. Now, I just showed you how to run Ubuntu apps in Bazzite with DistroBox. However, you can spin up, for example, an Arch container and play with the latest software available if you wish. Also, while DistroBox works very well in Bazzite, you're free to use it in virtually any other Linux distro. This concludes my first DistroBox video. Please like and comment if you found this guide helpful, and don't forget to subscribe for more tech guides. Thank you for watching. Have a great day. Goodbye.